welcome to Movie Review Mom. Thanks so much for spending a few minutes with me while we talk about movies. I know I'm the one doing all the talking, but I really appreciate that you're watching this. And thank you for supporting me and helping me to grow my YouTube channel. You can also find me on Facebook in a group called, guess what? Movie Review Mom. And I'm also on Instagram as Movie Review Mom and as myself, which is Trina Boyce. I don't know if you knew that was my name. Anyway, my goal is to give you the heads up on filmmaking quality and content so you can make the best decision for you and your family as to whether or not you want to spend time and money watching a specific film. In fact, I was just talking to my sister the other day and she's like, what's good to watch? We've been watching so many dumb movies and I keep forgetting to ask you what I should not watch in addition to what I should watch. And I said, well, let me tell you. Well, first of all, I told her to watch my YouTube channel. But anyway, let me tell you about a movie that I really do recommend. I'm going to give you tips for parents. I'll list things that I like and don't like, themes worth talking about, movie lines, and even recommendations for other films that I think that are sort of similar that I think you'll also enjoy. All right, let's dive in. So the movie I'm reviewing today is called Swan Song. This touching and dramatic movie is currently in theaters and streaming on Apple TV Plus. The movie is rated R and it's an hour and 52 minutes long. So in a nutshell, the film was written and directed by Benjamin Cleary, and it's his very first feature film. He has received critical acclaim and an Academy Award for his 2015 short called Stutterer. He's off to a really great start. Set in the near future, Swan Song is a powerful emotional journey told through the eyes of Cameron, played beautifully by Mahershala Ali. I adore him, and I'll tell you more about him in just a second. He's a loving husband and father in this movie who's expecting a second child with his wife, Poppy. Such a cute name. I have a neighbor who has a daughter named Poppy. Anyway, Poppy is played also beautifully by Naomi Harris. When Cameron is diagnosed with a terminal illness, he's presented with an alternative solution by his doctor, played by Glenn Close, to shield his family from grief and suffering. So as Cameron grapples with whether or not to alter his family's fate, he learns more about life and love than he ever imagined. The film explores how far we will go and how much we're willing to sacrifice to make a happier life for the people we love. So let me tell you about the things I loved about this movie. First of all, Mahershala Ali is gold. He's excellent in every movie that he does and has the many awards to prove it. I especially loved him in Green Book. I absolutely adore him and can't wait to see him in the upcoming Marvel movie called Blade. He'll be incredible, I'm sure. Mahershala and Naomi Harris make such a gorgeous and believable couple. I love them together. And in fact, they both starred in the movie Moonlight, where he also won that Academy Award for Best Performance. And they both received nominations for their touching performances in that film. It also won Best Picture of the Year. So it's a rough movie to watch, definitely not family friendly, with some R-rated content, but very beautifully made. Now, something amusing happens on a train at the beginning of this movie, and I actually read of that exact thing happening many years ago. It's a cute misunderstanding that shows the good nature of most people and allows you to immediately fall in love with this couple. I love the robot service on the train, the cool tech gadgets in this movie, and the self-driving car, and I can't wait till we have all of those things in our everyday world. Even still, the futuristic tech that's featured in this movie is really just to create a setting that allows us to readily accept the science of cloning people. It's not the focus of the film, but it provides a believable and interesting backdrop. The original score is just lovely. The element of music is also utilized to express happiness in one of the characters' lives. And so the title itself is appropriate. swan song. And I love double entendres, you know, because this is his final song, so to speak, before he dies. The montages make you realize how fast time flies by and that the beautiful moments of life are made up of all the small things that we experience in everyday life. Stunning landscapes and gorgeous cinematography. And from a mom's perspective, I can appreciate the sacrifice that the main character is willing to make for the happiness of his family. But I can also understand how conflicted he would feel about walking away from his family. The film perfectly displays the anger and even jealousy and sorrow that the protagonist is feeling while making this decision and really struggling with this decision. I thought it was really well illustrated. The sweet scenes will just bring tears to your eyes. It made me tear up. The ethical questions that the movie asks are intriguing, especially as our technology advances. The question isn't if we can clone creatures, for example, but should we clone creatures? Now, the relationship between twin siblings in the movie is also illustrated. I have a twin sister, so I loved that element thrown into the story about family dynamics and that very special bond. Awkwafina gives an excellent performance. She maintains her feisty spark, but with a subdued and powerful performance. The family's dog is completely adorable. And of course, the little boy is completely adorable. The minimalistic design underscores that when we get close to death, things become simplified. We can easily see what's the most important thing in our life. And for most people, that answer is relationships, more specifically your family. And the cast is very small and it allows you to really focus on the family. There's an element of mystery as the story slowly unfolds, revealing more about the characters and the plot. Now, there were just a few things that I didn't like. First of all, some viewers might be a little bit confused because the timeline bounces back and forth at times. Mahershala Ali also plays two different characters, which might also confuse viewers at times. There's a moment when I wondered if the movie would actually turn into a thriller or even a horror because something happens, but it passes and the questions that scene asks are never really answered. And I just kind of thought that was odd. Some viewers have complained that the movie's length is way too long and it drags on, but I actually disagree. Dying from a terminal illness must feel like it drags on while experiencing an emotional roller coaster. And so I thought that the film illustrated that feeling really well. Academy Award nominee Glenn Close is wonderful as expected and as always, but she was really underutilized in the film. Now, let me give you some tips for parents. There is some profanity and F-bombs. Kids ultimately are going to be bored. It's a talking adult movie kind of a thing. An adult gives alcohol to a child, and I totally understood the scene, but I was like, ah. And then, of course, there's talk of death. The themes that are worth talking about and that are illustrated well in the movie are love, sacrifice, and protecting our loved ones, pain, family and relationships, life, honesty and secrecy, greed, identity, cloning, humanity, jealousy, anger, and death, dying, and terminal illness. All right, so I always write down funny lines and interesting lines so I can kind of give you a taste of the film's content. And so I always write them down and include them on my moviereviewmom.com website, but I'll share a couple of them with you right now. One of the funny lines is spoken by Cameron, who's played by Mahershala Ali, and he says, "Ah, there's nothing like a good death chat first thing in the morning." And there are a lot of death chats in this movie, of course. And then an interesting line was spoken by Dr. Scott, played by Glenn Close. And she says, "It's hard to be left behind." And that leaving behind is illustrated in a variety of ways. Ultimately, I really enjoyed this film and my movie review mom grade is an A-. All right, but before we go, let me give you a recommendation for another film that's also still in theaters, and another one that demonstrates this love for family, and it's called A Journal for Jordan. You can see my movie review here on my YouTube channel, as well as on my website. And I love that it also offers a lovely African-American couple and their struggles in their relationships and between life and death, and some of the ways that they handle those difficult situations. All right, that is it for my review. I hope if you watch this movie that you really enjoy it and that you get something out of it, and specifically that you choose to really cherish every day that we have, because tomorrow's not promised. All right, have a fantastic day, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye for now.